Let's hope this works this time, because it keeps saying my card is full, but it's not, because it literally doesn't have anything on it. I just checked in my computer. And I don't know if you can tell, but I'm surrounded by diapers. Yes, it is finally the long-awaited diaper stash video. I've had a ton of people requesting this on YouTube comments and on my other social media, so I thought it would be super fun now that I have a ton of different styles and brands to go through with you and show you my current diaper collection. I will only be showing you one of each kind that I have, but trust me, I have a lot. If you follow me on my social media, you will see. There's only a few of these kind that I only have one of, and it's usually because I tried them out and I don't like them, or they're hard to get into the US. So let's get started. The first brand that I am starting with is Bambinos. I have a stack of 5 Bambino diapers that I have, and I have multiples of each kind. So I am going to go through with you, show you which ones they are. First one on the list is the classic Bambino Bianco. It is a plain white ABDL dip. It is 4 taped, and yeah, it's just nice because you can put stickers on it, or if you're feeling less babyish but still want to wear, you've got a good diaper to go to. Then obviously another classic, the Bambino Classico, which is also known as the Baby Blocks diaper. They have little blocks on it in different colors that say baby across it. They're super cute. Next on to the Bambino Teddy, which is, I love the teddy diaper because it's absolutely adorable. It has little teddies with diapers on, playing with balloons and balls. And a new favorite of mine, the Bambino Bellissimo. This one is thicker and has a higher absorbency rate than the other Bambinos, but it is still just as good. I mean, I love it. I'm wearing one right now. It's definitely become one of my favorites. And the last for Bambinos I have, I only have a few of these, is the brand new Bambino Magnifico. This one has little pastel dinosaurs and numbers all over it, and this one is a little bit different because it is a cloth and plastic hybrid, so it's got kind of like a latch hook system for the tapes. Instead of the tapes being regular tapes, it's like Velcro tapes. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's kind of cool, so you can readjust it literally as many times as you want, and you don't have to worry about the tapes losing stickiness, or you don't have to worry about the whole baby powder on the tapes tragedy that happens sometimes. And I'm pretty sure Bambino also came out with a Bianco version that is the same style as these. I think it's called the Bianco Ultra Stretch. On to the next brand I have, AB Universe. I have one from AB Universe that isn't here right now, but I figured since I already showed you a plain white diaper, I wasn't gonna show you another one that's virtually the same, and that is the ABU Simple. I have a half case of ABU Simple, but they are pretty similar to the Bambino Bianco. First on the list for ABU is the Super Dry Kids. This has an old Pampers print from the 90s on it with teddy bears, and it is a one tape diaper, and I'm not a huge fan of one tape diapers as is, but this is still a nice one, and it is pretty cute and brings back all those nostalgic memories. Next one for ABU is the ABU Lavender, which, yes, it smells like lavender. It's got these purple side paneling, and oh gosh, it smells so good. This is also a single tape diaper. The last single tape from ABU is one of my faves. It is the ABU Cushies. I don't know why, but I am so drawn to this print, and I love it so much, and it makes me feel like a real 90s baby. Get it? Now on to the 4 tapes from ABU. I have the quintessential space diaper, which everybody has to have, especially if you have the onesies down under space onesie, because you gotta be all matchy-matchy. Cool thing about this one is that the aliens disappear when wet. Then probably my all-time favorite diaper, which I'm actually running dangerously low on, so if anybody wants to gift me a bag, you know where to find me, is the ABU Little Paws. I love this because it's, well, green, and green is one of my favorite colors. It's got this cute checkered thing. The little paw prints in the middle disappear when wet, and this is just, in general, one of my faves. On to another great brand, and that is Rears. Rears is known for having the highest absorbency and thickest diapers in the market for ABDLs, littles, age regressors, all that, and frankly, I love Rears a lot. The first one is the new style single taped Rears Spoiled, which has little footprints on it, which makes me feel super babyish and small. Then another one of their newer ones, which is single taped, and I don't love this one, but I still wear it, and that is the Rears Little Squirts with this very cute underwater theme. Now, the very first Rears that I ever got, and I'm also running low on these ones, and they are adorable, is the Rears Princess Pink. This is one of my first diapers. I have old videos of me on this channel unboxing them for the first time, and luckily I still have a bag left, which is amazing because these are some of my absolute favorites. And then I also have the Rears Safari, which is so cute because they've got all these little different animals on them, and I have the Safari onesie from Rears, which has the same print, so wearing them together and being being all cute and matching. And from what I'm aware of, the very first diaper of its kind on the market, the Rears Seduction, which is an all black diaper. The tapes are still white, but it is all black all around, and I think that's pretty cool. I know the other brand that does black diapers in the US is Tykeables, but they have like a yellow strip down the middle because they're called like pleather, so they look like leather, but I personally like just the all black. Now on to another brand which I have worked closely with, and that is the Dotty Diaper Company. If you do not know, I sell the Dotty Diaper Company diapers in my shop as part of my beginner diaper box, and if you add a diaper to another box that you order. So you can choose between their two awesome prints, which is the Super Dotty the Pony, which holds 5,000 milliliters, as well as the Super Boompa. So this one is pink and it is got Dotty the Pony on. It's got little ponies all over it. And this one is more of a masculine style diaper with the superhero print and sides. I love Dotty a lot. They swell great when wet and they're pretty thin, which is good for discreet wearing out. On to a new fave of mine is the Diaper Connoisseur brand diapers. The first one is the iconic pink diaper, and that is the DC Amore. It has sparkles all over it and it's got this really cute like faded grid siding, and it's got little kitties that look like Marie from the Aristocats. The next one is the version 1 of the DC Idol. A lot of people call this the DC Amore blue, but it's actually called the DC Idol. It has teddy bears with balloons. They're not even teddy bears, they're like bears. Bears with balloons and in helicopters, and it's got this cute side paneling, which I really like. And then I also have the 2017 version of that diaper, which has the same print up here and on the side panels, but it is a nice light blue instead of the dark blue. We are reaching the end of my stash, but here I'm going to show you some like individual branded diapers that only make one or two for each like actual brand. They only make like one or two diapers instead of being a brand that makes like six different kinds. These brands only make like one kind. First is one of my favorites, which I am also running low on, and I'm so sad because, and I still can't afford them even though they're so cheap, but they are one of my favorites for wearing out and when I'm not feeling super babyish, and that is the Abina L4. This is the same as the M4. The L just stands for large, the M stands for medium, and I'm pretty sure they have an S4 and an XL4, but this is a really nice incontinence brand one. I do not like incontinence brand ones except for this one. It is pretty thick, and I think it beats Dotty and Tykeables in the thickness, and it's got the classic med strip down the middle. And this one has somehow bit me in the butt and creeped up to the top of my list. I did not know they existed until a couple months ago, and they are actually available on Amazon for $30 a bag, which is pretty cheap, and that is the Fab Sense City Print. I think I fell for this because it's green, and I love it, and it has like trees and music notes and like little buildings on it, and it's said to absorb 3,000 milliliters, but I've noticed it holds up on par with ABU at 5,000 mils, so this is the only one of this kind I have left, and that is a Crinkles. I am not a huge fan of Crinkles. You cannot get these here in the US very easily. They don't have a landing strip, and they are pretty much the L4, except crappier, you know what I mean? And they've got like a baby design on it, I mean. But this is the only one I have left. I do not intend on wearing it. I only intend on keeping it because it adds to my stash. Next is the very first diaper I ever tried, and that is the Tykeables Overnights. These are pretty thin, comparable to the Dotty Diaper Company diapers, but these are designed as an overnight diaper. These stars fade when wet, and they have this cute blue side paneling. And the very last one, a brand new diaper on the market that has also become one of my favorites, and that is the ABDL Shop's carousel diaper. I don't know if you can see it very well, but it has like a giraffe and a horse and a rabbit and an elephant on it, which I love, and it's got the little ABDL Shop logo, and it's got these pastel side panelings, and it really does look like a babyish diaper because it's pretty much all white except for the design and side paneling, and it's become one of my faves. These are available for $30 a bag, which is pretty inexpensive compared to a lot of other ABDL brands like Rears. And I just love them so much. So that's it. That is Riley's diaper stash. I might insert a picture or video of my actual like full stash, but don't count on it. If you want to see that though, head over to my social media. I show it a lot in live streams that I do on Instagram. And you can follow me over there to keep up with me pretty much every day. You can also subscribe to my two other channels that I have. I have a main channel and I have a vlog channel that are linked down in the description if you want to go follow me over there. And if you subscribe here and hit that bell button, you'll be notified every single time I upload a video and you will be in the notification crew, which is pretty cool. And I noticed we also broke 1,000 subscribers on this channel, and I wanted to say thank you so much for all of your support. It's really nice to have people coming together to support a channel that's for age regression instead of kink, because pretty much every single little YouTube channel out there is kink-based or DDLG-based, while my channel is based around CGLRE and safer work age regression, which makes it a little bit different. So thank you for all of the support from everybody who has subscribed to this channel and made it possible for me to keep doing the things that I love. I love you guys lots, and I will see you guys on Saturday, okay? Goodbye!